Back in 1100 A.D., I was a famous lay. See, and when my husband's charm was fading, he went away crusading. Went away to war and left me flat. I did not have time to think of that. War is war, and in war I knew there was work that only girls could do. So while the others were ballyhooing, night and day I was doing quiet little acts of charity. And what do you think they called me? Public sweetheart number one, loved by every mother's son. While my old man was away, I did one good deed each day. When the New Year's honors came, I refused the rank of dame, 'cause I had much more good clean fun as public sweetheart number one. When a crusader left his charmer, he had the girl encased in some little bit of his own armor, so she could keep her waist in. When the village blacksmith hammered me into my new set of lingerie, though I thrilled at the way it shone, I felt funny with a padlock on. 1 minute after my man departed, stormy weather had started. Who do you imagine called on me but Richard the Lion-hearted? Have you ever tried to run when your undies weighed a ton? I just looked at him and sighed. Ha-cha-cha-cha, was I fortified? How on earth could I foresee he possessed a master key, and the fireworks had begun for public sweetheart number one? Why did they call him Lion-hearted, though he was big and bony? I want to tell you, now we're parted, that it was all baloney. He might rave and rave his oriflamme, but that lion went out like a lamb. When I said you're a false alarm, give me Henry of Navarre for charm. For though people raved about Richard's torso, Henry's was even more so. And if you've ever wondered why, France is our closest ally. Chérie numéro un qui parle, started longtemps cordial, and the gag par excellence, honest walk in Malipon. When Henry took a trip back to France, I packed my grip, saying work round here is done, and public sweetheart.